It also fleshes out what the now familiar line of public payments for public goods might mean. Expect better air and water quality, healthier soils, more wildlife, lower greenhouse gas emissions, better access to the farmed countryside, and greater protection for its ancient heritage. The planned approach post-2022 will be a new land management system that puts the environment first. That sounds good. At first sight, it seems absurd that the Common Agricultural Policy hands 95% of its money to the wealthiest farmers, although that is because they have the largest farms and therefore produce the most. But critics believe the CPRE is putting a highly optimistic gloss on our farming future. The CPRE itself recognises there is a catch. This might mean spending a little bit more on our food, but would that be so bad? In truth, we spend less than any other EU nation except Luxembourg per head on our food. Our obsession with cheap food has not done our health, our farming, or our environment many favours, so this could be a turning point. The CPRE may be correct in all those assertions, although telling the British people that Brexit means paying more for food was not on the side of the 2016 Brexit campaign bus. Whatever the supposed benefits of spending a little bit more on our food, as seen by the relatively wealthy supporters of the CPRE, that will again not be good news for the less well-off, especially those who find themselves at the Trussell Trust's food banks. While many would welcome the proposed environmental benefits of Brexit for our farmland and food production, they are speculative and strongly disputed by some because they may not survive ambitious trade deals with the United States and other countries. The easiest trade deals in history.